The wage gap between men and women got a standing ovation at this year's Academy Awards. Remember Patricia Arquette's speech there? Well, now there's a move here in Phoenix to close that gap. Justin sat down with a Phoenix City Councilwoman today, hoping to make that happen. Justin?
Yeah, Katie, women's rights advocates and city officials are working now to add language to the city's anti-discrimination ordinance to make it clear that the city of Phoenix will not tolerate pay discrepancies when it comes to women doing the same job as men.
Sarah Pressler heads up the Arizona Foundation for Women. She knows firsthand about pay discrepancies, even at top-paying jobs.
So as a woman attorney, if I am hired by someone to write a brief, and a male attorney is hired by someone to write that same brief for that same topic in the same court system, I'm going to be paid 56 cents for that brief, and he's paid a dollar.
Phoenix City Councilwoman Kate Gallego is working to close those gaps for all local women. She's proposing a change in wording in our local ordinances that clarify the city's stance on equal pay for equal work. She's also proposing new efforts to educate women on the issues so they can make better decisions in negotiating.
Well, part of it is that women need to do more to help ourselves. We need to ask for fair compensation, and if we deserve a wage increase, we should ask for that raise, so women are less likely to ask.
In Phoenix, a woman makes an average of 82 cents on the dollar compared to a man with the same position. And while that's better than the national average of 70 cents for every dollar, for Sarah, it's not good enough.
79% of single-family households living in poverty in Arizona are headed by women. It tells us now more than ever that the investments we make today in Arizona's women and children will only pay off for our Arizona economy tomorrow.
So Gallego is going to make her proposal at the March 24th City Council meeting. If it's passed, the language will be put into contracts with all of the city's business partners. Katie?
Justin, thank you.